Welcome to another episode of Art of Animation Distance Learning Series. This week, we will make a walk cycle animation using the cutout puppet we made in one of the previous episodes. Walk cycle is a very important topic in animation. When humans and animals walk, they make some characteristic moves with their legs and arms. In order to mimic walking in stage, we need to think about different poses of the body in different moments of the movement. Let's start making this animation. I will capture and animate the frames with my smartphone camera and Stop Motion Studio software. Here I will use paper as a simple stage. My puppet is 15 cm in length. If you think about human length to step length ratio, my puppet can move 7 cm in each of his steps. I choose 24 frames as frame count for this cycle. My puppet will move 2 steps in 24 frames. The last pose of my puppet will be at 25th frame and it will be the same pose with the first frame. FPS value of this project is 24 frames per second. So the movement will be happening 1 second. I draw a 14 cm line on the paper representing 2 7 cm steps. I marked where the body should be in extreme frames when both legs are wide and on the ground. I also marked body positions in breakdown frames. By adding in-betweens, I converted this to a timeline and I wrote down frame numbers on these locations. 1, 13 and 25 for extremes. 7 and 19 for breakdowns. 4, 10, 16 and 22 for in-betweens. These lines, marks and frame numbers will make it easier to control the movement and poses on stage. I'm starting with the first pose. Both feet of the puppet is on the ground. One is at the front, other at back. Arms are wide. They are converted compared to legs. I'm taking the first picture in this pose. From this frame to 7th frame, my puppet go from a 2 legs touching pose to standing on 1 leg pose. In the 2nd frame, he gives weight to front leg and starts pulling his back leg. Back feet is not touching the ground anymore and knee of the back leg starts bending slowly. Arms get close slightly. In the 3rd frame, the closing of the arms continue. The body moves a bit forward, more weight on the front leg. Fourth frame is marked on my timeline to show that my puppet is equal distance to first extreme and first breakdown frames. In the middle of these, arms are getting closer. I'm taking the 5th frame following the same logic. Next frame is the 6th one. In this frame, upper legs are in the same line, overlapping. Also, arms are nearly overlapping. 7th frame is the breakdown pose. My puppet is standing straight and arms are overlapping. The knee of the back leg bended to its maximum and also past the border of the front leg. In this frame, arms will start getting separated from each other. Back leg starts crossing the front leg. In 9th frame, the leg which comes from back becomes the front leg by completely passing the other. Body of the puppet gets closer to ground again. Arms get wider. Starting from 10th frame, I'm taking rapid shots without commentary. Follow carefully the pose of the puppet in each frame. Pause if necessary. Finally, in the 25th frame, we return to same pose with first frame. Two steps of the cycle is done. If we choose 24 FPS in settings of the Stop Motion Studio, our animation will be 1 second long. Let's see the result. Since I used this line below the puppet, both as a ruler and a timeline, my movement is relatively smooth. This was just for practice. You can think different methods and create your own tricks to study walking movement of human and animals. This week we applied walking cycle using a cutout puppet. Thank you all for watching and take care.